Assalamu alaikum. Today the topic that I am going to discuss is signaling pathways involved in cancer. So before starting the presentation, let's have a look at the content that I am going to discuss. After this presentation, you will be able to know about what is cancer, what are the pathways involved in cancer, and what are the treatments for cancer. For the better understanding of what is cancer, we will further discuss cell cycle and its checkpoint, drivers of cell cycle and their importance, oncogenesis and tumor suppressing gene. The pathways that are involved in cancer are many, but we will discuss only three of them, and that are P53 tumor gene pathway, PI3K AKT mTOR pathway, EGF signal transduction pathway. Start with a very basic introduction. What is cancer? We all know that cancer is the uncontrolled growth of abnormal cells anywhere in a body. These cells can infiltrate, or you can say penetrate, normal body tissues. So for the better understanding of the mechanism of cancer, we need to recall cell cycle. Cell cycle has four phases: G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase, M phase. G1 phase is the first phase of cell cycle in which the cell organelles like mitochondria replicates. In the S phase, that is also known as synthesis phase, in this phase the genetic material or DNA of a cell replicate. In the G2 phase, the cell again essentially grows and prepares itself for the mitotic phase, that is M phase. And the M phase is the last phase of cell cycle, also known as mitotic phase. In this phase, cells finally divided into two equal cells. So from the picture, we can see that cell cycle seems like a continuous pathway. So anything can go wrong. So there are some checkpoints that make sure that there is no problem along the way. So there are three checkpoints. The first is on the G1 phase, known as G1 checkpoint. It makes sure that the cell that is now going to enter into the cell cycle doesn't contain any tumor. Then the second checkpoint is on the G2 phase, known as G2 checkpoint. It makes sure that the cell that is now going to enter into the M phase doesn't contain any damaged DNA. And then the last checkpoint is on the M phase, known as metaphase checkpoint. It checks for chromosome spindle attachment. As we can see, that cell cycle is a continuous pathway from one phase to another, means from G1 to S to G2 to M. So what is the actual thing that progresses cell from one phase to another? So the thing that makes cell to progress from one phase to another are basically the drivers of cell cycle. These drivers are cyclins and CDKs. At the time when a cell enters into the cell cycle, it starts producing proteins that are cyclins and CDKs. These cyclins and CDKs then allow that cell to move into the cell cycle. For example, if there is a cell who wants to enter into the cell cycle, so before entering into the first phase, the cell will produce cyclin D and CDK2. This cyclin D and CDK2 will combine and release E2F. E2F is basically a transcription factor, and it will allow the cell to move into the G1 phase. When a cell is now is in G1 phase, it will produce cyclin E and CDK2. This cyclin E and CDK2 will produce transcription factor that will allow cell to move from G1 to S. In the S phase, cell will produce cyclin A and CDK2 that again will produce some kind of transcription factor that will make it progress from this phase, S phase, to the G2 phase. And then in the G2 phase, cell produces cyclin B and CDK1 that again produces some transcription factor that make it to progress from G2 phase to the M phase. The cyclins and CDKs are basically the drivers of cell cycle because they drive cell cycle. So now we can say if we are having a low amount of cyclins and CDKs, So it means that cell cycle would not progress. But if we are having a high amount or too much amount of cyclins and CDKs in our cell, so it means that cells will keep entering into the cell cycle, and at the end we will have uncontrolled growth of cells. And that uncontrolled growth of cell is one of the mechanism of cancer. So what is the importance of cell cycle checkpoints and regulation? The cell cycle of each cell must be precisely controlled and timed to faithfully and reproducibly complete the developmental program in every individual. Each type of cell in every tissue must control its replication precisely for normal development. In a normal adult, cells divide only when and where they are needed. However, loss of normal controls on cell replication is the fundamental defect in cancer. Here we have completed the mechanism of cancer. Now let's jump into the signaling pathways that are involved in cancer. Signaling pathways involved in cancer. So there are many pathways in human body that are basically involved in cancer, but we will discuss only three. But before discussing those pathways, I want to let you know that all these pathways at the end causes increase in oncogenesis, decrease in apoptosis, and decrease in tumor suppressing genes. Increase in oncogenesis. Oncogenesis means synthesis of oncogene. Oncogene is a gene that has ability to produce cancer cells. So obviously, in cancer, oncogenesis increases, meaning the production of oncogene or cancer cell increases. The second is decrease in apoptosis. Apoptosis means programmed cell death. For example, if a cell has completed its life cycle, has no function left to perform, and has used all its nutrients, then cell's own machinery kills itself because that cell is now useless. We don't want it more in our body. So therefore, it's a very necessary mechanism. But in cancer, apoptosis decreases. Then the last is decrease in tumor suppressing gene. Tumor suppressing genes are those genes that suppresses tumor. But in cancer, these tumor suppressing genes decreases. So it means that tumor doesn't suppress and tumor grow. When tumor grow, it ultimately led to cancer. Now the very first pathway we are going to discuss is p53 tumor gene pathway. First we will discuss the normal functioning of this pathway and the importance of this pathway. Then we will discuss that what happened in cancer state. First, normally what happened, if any cell is having a damaged DNA, it produces tumor suppressing genes like p53. p53 is tumor suppressing gene. This p53 then act as a transcription factor. When it is transcribed and translated, it forms various proteins. What kind of proteins? The number one protein is for cell arrest. And the protein for cell arrest is basically P21, shown in green color. This P21 causes cell arrest. It means that it arrests cell. If there is a cell who is having a damaged DNA and we don't want that cell to enter into the cell cycle and complete cell cycle, so our cell will produce P21 that will go and arrest the cell. How? By inhibiting the CDKs and cyclins. Inhibiting the CDKs and cyclins mean P21 is basically inhibiting the drivers of cell cycle. When it inhibits the driver of cell cycle, the cell cycle stops and this cell cannot grow. Then the second protein that it forms is for DNA repair. It repairs DNA. The cell that is now arrested, these proteins will go to that cell and try to fix the damaged DNA, try to repair that damaged DNA. But in case if these proteins fail to fix that DNA, so it will produce another protein that is for cell apoptosis, for cell killing. Then these proteins will come and kill that cell because we don't want any tumor in our body. So now you can see that how much P53 is important in our body to suppress tumor and to prevent us from cancer. Now can you imagine what will happen if there will be a mutation in P53? So if there will be a mutation in p53, it means that now our body isn't making protein for cell arrest, it's not making protein for DNA repair, and it's not making protein for cell apoptosis. When our cell is not making these proteins, so it means that if a cell having a damaged DNA can easily move into the cell cycle and can cross all the checkpoints because there are no proteins that can suppress it. So ultimately, it will lead to cancer. The second pathway is PI3K-AKT-mTOR pathway. PI3K-AKT-mTOR pathway is normally a living pathway. It is known as a living pathway because it produces protein for cell growth, cell progression, division, and survival. First, we will also discuss its normal functioning and then the cancer state. So normally what happens if any growth factor as a signaling molecule comes and binds, this growth factor could be of any type. It could be either epidermal growth factor, it could be either platelet-derived growth factor or any other growth factor. When growth factors come and bind on the receptor tyrosine kinase, it makes this receptor activated. How? The receptor tyrosine kinase cross-phosphorylate each other at tyrosine residues. When they get active, they then activate an other signaling molecule present in the cytosol, that is PI3K. This PI3K has an ability to convert this PIP2 into the active state, that is PIP3. PI3K adds one phosphate into the PIP2 and makes it PIP3. PIP3 is now an activated state. This active protein then will activate PDK1. This PDK1 then active AKT. This AKT then activate mTOR. mTOR then finally activates the transcription factor that then make protein for cell growth, cell progression, and survival. So when we have made the proteins for cell growth and we don't want more proteins, so there is a molecule known as P10 present in our cell cytosol that comes and remove the phosphate from the PIP3 and convert it back into the inactive state so that the whole cascade can stop. But in cancer state, what happened that the gene that is coding for P10 due to some mutation got blocked or knocked out. When it is mutated, so it means that now our cell doesn't have P10. When our cell doesn't have P10, so it means that now we cannot remove this phosphate from PIP3. So this PIP3 will always be active. When it will always be active, this whole cascade will keep continuing. And at the end, what will happen? We will have a lot of production of protein for cell growth, cell progression, and survival. And ultimately, it will lead to cancer. The last pathway that we are going to discuss is EGF signal transduction pathway. EGF means epidermal growth factor. When a signaling molecule, that is epidermal growth factor, comes and binds to the receptor tyrosine kinase, it makes these receptor autophosphorylate or cross-phosphorylate each other and make them active. When it gets active, it activates an adaptor protein found in our cytosol known as GRB2. This adaptor protein, when gets activated, it allows SOS to come and bind to it. When SOS comes and bind to GRB2, it gets activated. When SOS gets activated, it then activates RAS protein. This RAS protein here is in its inactive form because it has GDP attached to it. Whenever there is GDP attached to a protein, it is in its off state. This SOS remove this GTP from the RAS protein and add GTP instead. When it adds GTP, now this RAS protein is activated. This activated RAS protein then will activate RAF. This RAF then will activate MEK. This MEK then will activate ERK. This ERK protein then will go into the nucleus and finally phosphorylate that gene that is now going to act as a transcription factor. And it is ELK1. When ELK1 gene gets phosphorylated, it acts as a transcription factor. When it is transcribed and translated, it forms the various proteins that are required for growth. So now the inability of our cell to regulate signal transduction pathway can lead to tumor and cancer. So we must need to terminate these signaling pathways to prevent our body or cells from cancer. So recall that cells terminate signal pathway in three ways. They have GTPase activity to terminate pathway. They have phosphatases to terminate pathway because they reverse the effect of protein kinases. And the last way to terminate signaling pathway is the inactivation of receptor. GTPase activity means cell is having an activity to remove GTP from the RAS protein. When it removes GTP, the RAS protein gets inactivated. When it gets inactivated, the whole signaling pathway terminates. Then we are having phosphatases. These phosphatases act as these phosphatases are basically the enzymes that have an ability to remove these phosphates from the proteins. When phosphatases remove these proteins from the proteins, so it means that now they are inactivated. When they are inactivated, so this signaling pathway terminates. And the last is inactivation of receptor. When we don't want more proteins, these receptor detaches. When they detaches, this whole signaling pathway terminates. But what happens in cancer state? Cancer occurs when cell loses all these three activities. When it loses GTPase activity, when it loses phosphatases, and when it loses the ability to inactivating the receptor. When cell doesn't have GTPase activity, it means that now our cell cannot remove this GTP. When it cannot remove this GTP, the RAS will always be in active position and this whole cascade will keep continuing. And at the end, we will have overproduction of proteins for cell growth, and it is one of the mechanisms of cancer. Now think, if we are not having phosphatases, when we are not having a phosphatases, it means that now we cannot inactivate these proteins. We aren't having an enzyme to inactivate these proteins. So when there is no phosphatase, so these proteins will always be active and this cascade or the signaling pathway cannot terminate. When it cannot terminate, obviously we are having an overproduction of proteins for cell growth and it will ultimately lead to cancer. And sometimes what happens that a cell lose its ability to inactivate the receptor. In this case, what happened that the receptor doesn't detaches, it remains attached and the signaling pathway cannot terminate, and it is also a cause of cancer. Now treatment of cancer. I am having here an example of Herceptin drug for HER2 receptor in breast cancer. It has been observed that most of the cases mean 30% of the individuals who are having a breast cancer is because of the overproduction or overexpression of this receptor HER2 on the cell membrane. Due to the presence of these receptors in high amount, the signaling pathway overexpresses. When signaling pathway overexpresses, so at the end we are having an overproduction of cell growth that is causing the cancer. But we can somehow control this. How? The patients who are having a breast cancer are given Herceptin drug. This Herceptin drug go and bind to the HER2 receptor. When this Herceptin drug binds to the HER2 receptor, it doesn't allow signaling molecules to come and bind onto the active site because Herceptin block active sites of the HER2. When it blocks the active site of HER2, so it means that now no signaling pathway, signaling molecule can come and bind to the receptor, and there will be no more production of the cancer cells. So that is how we can control it. Thank you.